Hey everyone, it's Dale, and I want to show you what it's like to take a look around Google Analytics. And we're going to show you the power of Google Analytics and how it can affect the strategy that it comes with the content on your site. Now, just a brief overview, Google Analytics is a free tool and it tracks visitors and your website. So it tracks how they got to your website, and it tracks what they do once they get to your website. So that's a ton of data that we can use to affect strategy moving forward. Now, I should mention, anyone can use Google Analytics as long as they have a self-hosted site, meaning you have it up on a server somewhere. For the FDOM class, we're using a free WordPress-hosted blog, so you won't be able to go in and put Google Analytics on your site. But if you take WebPub or you take another class moving forward and you do have a self-hosted site, you can easily put Google Analytics on there and get all this data. Again, it's free. You just have to sign up and put the code on your site and you'll start getting the data from Google. So let's walk you through what it looks like once you do get that information and that code installed on your self-hosted page. Again, this won't work on our free WordPress blogs. But the first thing to do is go to google.com/analytics. And this is the homepage. And if I click right here on sign in, so I'm already logged in to Google. And you can see we're now taking a look at the MassCom, the SJMC website, and the Google Analytics behind this. Here's a look at the homepage. Again, we're going to be analyzing what people do once they come to our homepage. A couple of things that we already know about our site in general. One, students use it for information. You come here for specific reasons. Two, you might be looking up specific things. So we'll be talking about our degree plans and things along those lines. You might be looking for our social media accounts. You might be looking for faculty bios, things along that. So heavily student-oriented. We've taken great strides in making the site more visual over the past couple of years with fresh content. So lots of nice changes over the past couple of years with the SJMC site. All right, so we're back here on the analytics homepage, and you can see we have kind of a dashboard here with a lot of information that we can view right now. We can see when our users visit the site more often. You can see we're particularly heavy Tuesday through Thursday around, 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., which makes sense. That's when a lot of students are on campus. You can see in the past week, here are our general numbers. We've had more than 1,000 users. Bounce rate is when a user comes to the site and leaves immediately. You want that bounce rate number to be as low as possible. And you can see in general, students spend about 2 minutes. I'm saying students, it's probably, you can assume that most of our traffic is students are spending about 2 minutes per visit to our site. You can see we actually have two people on the site right now. One of those is actually me because I'm on the site. And so you can get some real-time traffic. You can go into all these and start looking at all of this data that they make available to you through the dashboard. But I want to walk you through this left-hand column over here. And we're going to spend the most of our time talking here about the audience tab and the acquisition tab. Because for most of us, that's going to be where we want the majority of our information to come from. So I'm going to click here on audience and I'm going to go to overview. And the default time frame is going to be about a week. And I've already gone in and changed that to January 1st. Through March 1st when I'm recording this little walkthrough here. So you can see our traffic to the site, and you'll notice we have peaks and valleys here. That makes total sense, because how often are you on the Texas State website on the weekends? Students are primarily going to be visiting the site during the week. So that makes total sense when you think about those peaks and valleys that you see here. Here's some overall user information. Again, for this time frame, you can see we've had 7,093 users. The majority of those have been new users, but we'll talk about that here in just a second. You can see some of those have come multiple times, so they've had multiple sessions. We have almost 20,000 page views, and we've had about 10,000 sessions. So we average about 2 page views per session when you do that math there. You can see
Again, majority of times about 2 minutes people are spending on the site, and we have a bounce rate about 52%. You can see the languages that people are using, and we can continue to go on through digging through the analytics there. So let's go through some of these other things, and let's start with audience, and let's go to demographics and click on overview. Again, this is for that time frame here, January 21st through March 1st. The majority of our users are 18 to 24. That makes total sense again when you think about it. It's primarily going to be students using our site. Our gender breakdown almost goes perfectly with the School of Journalism and Mass Communications gender breakdown. It's about 60-40 female to male, so that makes sense as well. If I go right here to geo, let's click on some information there. Let's go to location. And this is some really important information. So this will tell you all the countries where your audience is coming from. Sorry, location, not language. So you can see here about 92% of our traffic's coming from the United States. And we might have some other international students looking us up. Some of these might be spam, so you have to keep that in mind. You can click on city right there to see where people are clicking from. You can see San Marcos is number one. That makes total sense. And then we have the major cities in Texas. We have Round Rock, since we have the Round Rock campus. We have Chicago, which that's a little weird, but you never know, might be out of state students. You can continue going up and down this list here. If I click on behavior, and let's click on new versus returning. So I mentioned I would want to talk about this. You can see if you might think that students would continually keep coming back to the site, and that probably actually is happening. But the reason why new visitor is number one here, or you know, about 75% of the audience is new, is because every time you visit on a new computer, it counts you as a new visitor. So if one person checks in on their laptop and goes to the site, and then they go down to the lab in the Media Innovation Lab and go on one of the iMacs there, then they go to Alkek and go to the site, and then they view on their phone, that counts as 4 new visitors. So chances are those numbers are a little misleading when you think of that. If I click on technology, you can see which browsers they're using. You can see Chrome and Safari. Safari probably because of all the Macs in the labs. Chrome is probably everyone on their laptop, so their home computers. You can see Safari on mobile down here. And we talked in class that Internet Explorer drives developers crazy. So here's how you can see, you know, if we have a number, it's not a huge number, but we do have some people using Internet Explorer. About 3% of our audience uses Internet Explorer. So we have to make sure the site is working on Internet Explorer. Then if you click on mobile, and let's click on overview, you can see where this takes us. This shows us that about 60% of our audience views our site on a desktop. That's desktop meaning either a laptop or in one of the labs, or you know, an iMac at home or something like that. Mobile is obviously on the phone, and then we have a small amount of students using a tablet in order to see our page. If we click up here, let's see, if we click here on acquisition, and this is the other one where I want to spend just a little bit of time talking about this. You can see that we're still looking January 21st through March 1st of this year. And this actually shows how people came to your website. So it's going to measure 4 different things here. Organic searches means they went to Google and they started searching for your site. So they started searching either keywords, or they found it when they searched for Texas State or Mass Comm or something like that in order to do that. Direct means they typed in masscom.txstate.edu into the URL of the browser and then went directly to the site. Referral will mean they came to you from a link somewhere, and you can see we get a small amount of traffic from social. So if I actually click here on organic search, you can see here this used to provide a lot of great detail on the keywords that people use to search for us. Google made a big change last year where they no longer provide the keywords. So you can see here, not provided is like 98% of our keywords, meaning they don't provide that information. If you're logged into Google or you're logged into YouTube or anything like that, It used to protect your information. Now it just protects it for just about anyone. So let me go back here to the overview page and let's click on referrals. This will show you all the links that are sending traffic your way. So you can see we have a link on the Texas State homepage, the admissions page, the course catalog, tracks, College of Fine Arts, all are sending traffic to our page. Those are the links. They're the referral links that are heading our way to the MassCom website. So if I go back to overview and let's click on direct now, you can see these are the pages where people are going to. So they're typing in these URLs directly. You can see we have a lot of people going to the degree plan. We have a lot of people going to the digital media innovation page, the electronic media, general MassCom, so on and so forth. And then lastly, if we click on social, you can see we get some traffic from Facebook, a couple of hits from Twitter, a couple from WordPress, LinkedIn, Blogger, and Instagram, but not a whole lot. So that's going to be the majority of the content we would probably want to focus on. It's like the beginner's guide to Google Analytics. You can continue clicking on any of these options here on the left-hand side. You could spend hours and hours looking at things here and getting information about your audience.